So we see it's quite tricky, the whole story of finding the starting, the start of the symbol. So this problem with the cyclic prefix is that if we're looking at the cross correlation here, and this is here our sample number n. Remember, so what we do is that this is our symbol, and that we copy this here to the front. So that's our symbol length t, and this is here our prefix. So as I said before, because of the cross correlation, what we do here, we should get a maximum cross correlation here at this point here. Maximum cross correlation here. So if we doing a sliding cross correlation over this here, then this looks probably like this. Then it goes down again. And then here at this point, this should be the start of the symbol. Now the problem is, because this is randomized data here, that this peak will be never, so that it's basically only reaching its peak here exactly at one pixel or at one sample. So if we zoom in here and having a look how this looks like in a zoomed in version, then this will probably look like that. So that this peak here has multiple maxima. So therefore, it's probably hard to detect the start of the symbol exactly by one sample. Hard to detect the exact start due to multiple local maxima. This is because we're using a random number generator here. So therefore, we never know exactly what we're getting here at this point. Obviously, theoretically, this should be just one point, but these are random numbers, so it can never guarantee that it's exactly sitting there with one maximum. So we're always having a certain uncertainty here where the actual start is. Yeah, so, but what we need is really the exact start or the exact sample number. So that's a problem, so we need to solve that.